mean?
I think it's like you don't want to get rid of your Chromatic Blade, but you want to get a new item.
Sure, that makes a lot of sense there. Now we are in the pit. Epicenter is going to start things through. BKBs are used, and now he baits out the BKB and Kyo. Kyo goes in, but the Yule Scepter is going to bait him even further. Meanwhile, on the right side, Ohio trying to get people killed, but the Fissure is just blocking everybody off. So far, CK is the only one dies.
He needs to get on this Invoker, but he's not able to focus on him. Now jumping in onto mid one. Doesn't have the Abyssal Blade yet. He's been saving for that buyback, and it might end up causing him no BKB. Overwhelmed by nuke damage. Secret gets the kill. That Fissure really did shut them down. As for the target selection, he spent so much time focusing on Yapzor, and every time Yapzor gets jumped, he fuels himself. That is basically the whole BKB duration. Mid one is doing whatever
he's got the blink, the BKB. They look like they want to go for an engage. GH trying to just mess with them a bit here, though.
He almost died there. There was a Winter's Curse used as well. He still gets the kill. That means that there's no Winter's Curse this fight, but Parshka still goes down at the start. Miracle making sure that jumping in with his remnants. Rezo.
Nice stun dodge by the Yules.
Yeah, but he blinks out because he doesn't have a lot of remnants. He's got one remnant left and he wants to maybe use that aggressively, perhaps.
Got an Arcane Rune as well.
Jewel, that was again Clockwork, nobody noticed.
Oh my goodness, and they're going to get Rezo off of all this too.
Yeah, that is a nice kill. Triple kill already coming out for Miracle.
Oh god, Arcane Rune Ember is so disgusting. Having all those spells up every like 4 seconds is so absurd. But that was a cool little bait play though. You see GH jumps in, pays with his life, but he forces the God Strength to come out and everything, and the BKB to come out early. That they're
a really sloppy death because of that reason alone. Roshan is up. Bottom lane is relatively shoved in. Like the only reason you're down there is to die, really. Yeah, that's just a sloppy death, because now Liquid have this opening. If he doesn't die there, TNC, they push out the waves up at top. You just let Sam H.
I spent Macro Pyre coming up from 1-7.
Oh, this is huge for them, though.
Yeah,
this is still a fight that Liquid wants to take, though. It is 4v5, but...
Oh, that bear is already dead. Burrow Epicenter coming out from Kuro, though. Almost kills off Tim's and 1-4-3-7,
but quite
doesn't.
Die, though.
Sam H drops to Miracle, but Miracle is already on the retreat. His Cuckoo is on his tail. He's trying to get him. Kuroki, not able to get away from this one. There you go. 1-4-3-7 gets him, and Miracle drops as well. That is a 5-man wipe, and they didn't even have a Lycan.
That was still a fight that Liquid had to take, though. It was a
25 and whatnot, but let's have that debate for a different day as EG is. Awesome.
We'll put our Enigma Chop Shop on hold as EG make their move through the river. Ooh. Lurking on the high ground.
Arcane Rune.
Our secret, and they were scouted by a Radiant Scan, but Yapzor's gonna jump in first, tries to bait something out. A little extra shenanigans for him. Now Sumail confidently lumbering up with the Shiva's Echo Initiation. He gets the party started. Zai's there to follow up. Look for the hole. He's got to find
you.
That's three. Universe, you monster! How could you? Puppy and all his monitors are in shambles. Secret on the run, completely overwhelmed.
He didn't get the Klinks, and he was taking quite a bit of damage, but his teams backed him up. They had a disarm, they had a Yules. Klinks did not do any damage in that team fight. And with a big win, EG goes straight for the Raxxas backdoor protection.
It could also be them winning the game if they kill no one. Yeah, you said you didn't like to see these teams playing not play to win. That's exactly what Hellraiser did.
My god, he just walked with the meatball! Waltzing along, now Ramsey's gonna be able to come in, missing a lot, but he's gonna be able to take down J4, it looks like Swift Ending. Pops the Chronosphere, looking for it, throws it down now, but it's gonna be a little bit late. The Troll's gonna make his way in, 33, goes for the hookshot, gets blasted into the Chronosphere, and Ramsey executes him. Vaughn comes in with the Epicenter, he's gonna be able to take down the puck, Green solo low, 33 managed to take that kill, while Troll, he managed fight, gets the bash going for Ramsey's. It's big if he can actually bring him down, but it looks like it's just not enough, because Lil's sitting in the site with an Aghanim Scepter, managed to get the stun onto Kaiser, 2-man Burrow Strike. They need to be able to kill one of these big time cores, but they're just getting kited around. Swift Ending comes toward, goes straight for Swift Ending, but he doesn't have BKB, so he's just getting stunned up by Lil. He's controlling these heroes. A tornado brings both of the cores up and down to their deaths. Hellraiser's on the clock for 2 minutes on two of their cores.
Bulb! I don't think I've ever seen a Burrow Strike that small. That was like a Burrow scrape the edge of the, scrape the surface of the floor. They will get him. It commits the global for it, though. And that's all they get. The Omni. Well, there's a mid lane Omni. Maybe they get the Arfu Pudge as well. Arfu in the tree line, does bring Bulba into him, looking for the deny, not going to get it. Ferev gets the double kill. Now they're looking for more. The damage of the Drow lineup rips through DDC, and they're not quite done. Monet looking to duke out the damage there with the ultimate, turns towards Bulba, crits him down. But Monet, can he on the top of his way out of this one? He cannot. He's down as well. Triple kill for Ferev. And Ferev showing us that you do not upgrade your boots, boys and girls, as the brown boots come into play.
He might just take over this game in terms of physical damage output. Between BKB and evasion, there's very little Alpha could do right now. KP comes in, he's gonna get found, is he gonna get lasso? That's a question. He orbs to the right side and he just dies. Tunnel vigiling on the fight in the mid lane, he wasn't watching his hero. Now Fissure clips on Kaka. Global comes in again late, maybe protecting
SC. They've still got a lasso though. This Batrider's not giving up just yet. Flamebreak pulls as Triple C closer into the clutches. Batman can't quite wrangle him in. Now the buyback. Newbie still want to take this fight, but the BKB's up on Monet, and he stands there like a bulwark against the offense. In comes Kaka, Dragon Tail before he can burrow, he hesitates, he's getting punished for it. Now likely to go down, Super finishes him off, just a bit slow on the trigger, and still Abu waiting for that Echo opportunity. Really doesn't need it, he still has an impact without it. The Batrider may have overplayed his hand, he's got the lasso, can he get it off?
No. Still.
Newbie bring him down, and now Abu strikes! Nailing them with the Echo, and then to the cross comes the Fissure. He hits all three, cleans them up, and KOs Newbie out of the match and out of their opportunity to take a game off LFY. They are still undefeated.
They're just going to push this in. And like I said, first Aegis normally can't do too much with it. You get all the tier 2 towers. Huskar is the one hero that's sort of the exception to this rule where you can just immediately go for the high ground. That's exactly what they're going to do. Take this tower and TNC. They need this. They need their Tinker life to be able to defend any of this, and that's a set of racks down at 23 minutes.
It's a rough one to take. Sprout up on Raven. Use Yules, pops it on the Shrine. Nice burrow epi from Tims, trying to force them back out of his base. The two-man pops the blade bill, gets caught as well. He's taking a lot of damage here, but he's okay for the moment. Raven coming in, taking the kill in the end, still mind control, silencing up Raven again. Raven, invisible for the moment, in a Glimmer Cave, goes again for the Nature's Prophet, sprout up. Can a Mind Control stay alive through all of this? He's just attacking people. He might not be attacking people for long, though. He does end up dropping Raven. He has got a Yuuzhan available, using up G8, but he still drops to Kuroki. 3-4-3 right now as Kuroki ends up dying to the Rockets of Cuckoo, who's still in the back lines, making sure.
Oh, he's gonna get stunned up now.
Oh, he's gonna get more than stunned up. He's gonna get obliterated. This was this is gonna be the finishing up later racks. Four dead Stand King is the only one alive.
Yeah, and because you
still, we'll see what he goes for as his next item. As we've been saying, Fnatic need to be more careful with these fights. Giving a lot of way to Empire after those last two situations. Maybe they can get a free pick here that will spot Meposhka out on the front lines of it all.
Oh,
bam! He's gone. Rezo, he wants to get...
Oh no! Fnatic, not like this! Jumped on by Rezo. Q pops the BKB. That is not going to save him from Rezo. Chunking him down. He's got a fair bit of movement speed, but Roger's flying across. Should be able to find the connection, and he does. Jump forward from Resolution and Ghost Stick. They get team once again! They're all dead. Roger, I couldn't have said it better myself.
I think Fnatic will be...
I'm gonna be honest, I haven't had the chance to see any of Fnatic's games, but...
Just a tiny bit. But these scrappy engagements, it's very close. And now it's secondary, or no, still same Roshan, sorry. The first one never died.
First one never died, but the scan is there. They know that Roshan's being done. They draw a beeline on the map from the base to Roshan, but are they gonna be in time?
This time they've got Medallion and Invoker's there with the Alacrity, but here comes Empire.
Now let's see. There is no Echo Slam available for another 50 seconds. FN just jumps in there for a bit. Ghostic does get a nice...
He's only got one Remnant now on FN. He ended up having to expend two there.
Ooh, Rezo, be careful there. Ooh, he goes for GH actually. In the meantime, the Jewel, that is Kuroki down as well. That is two dead on the side of Liquid. They do get the Aegis though. Mind Control getting chased down by Roger, but Roger himself getting taken down by Matuma Man. Unstoppable for him. Tornado Miracle back in this fight. He's got that Aegis. He's feeling confident. He goes for FN. That was his final Remnant. Is there an escape for him?
Oh,
nice
deafening
blast up on three. The perfect angle for Miracle. Double kill for Matuma Man. And Meposhka, he's just trying to run an iron, but he's just a poor little old lich.
So we're talking next. Woo! It's the Invoker, you know.
Oh. Hello, Rezo. He does not. He's dead.
Yeah, he's dead.